40 centimeters, but not very big at all. We cut off the branches because it's very strong one once. And when you see that, all the branches come to the trail, and with the crane you can get it back in the forest, but not that far. So we cut off the crowns, a bit of the crowns, and from the bigger trees like that, with some nasty branches with it's very bad for the Hypro, we cut it off in the forest and then make the tree with the Hypro. As you see, the machine is standing very well, and I want to show why that's like. At the lower links we had the bolts in there, so the links cannot move very much. And the good thing of that is we can lift up the front axle, so we can get the maximum weight on the Hypro. And that's the reason why the Hypro isn't moving sideways and also not keeping the getting over. Yeah, and you see also the chains to use to drive on the road. These are 10 millimeter chains, and that secure that this cylinder don't break. So we give torsion, a bit torsion on the chain, and when we hit the road bump or something, it's not only holding the cylinder, so chain also holding that overload. One thing I forgot, the Hypro says this tree has 30 centimeters and not 40. We measure there the 40, but the Hypro is also right, because there are only 40 centimeters there. So the Hypro is quite accurate, because the tree is going, it's getting small very fast. So it's not the biggest tree, but the problem is when the crane is on the maximum range, then the lifting capacity is not that good. It works, it was never a problem, but when you have a tree with 40 or 45, it's enough for that machine. That the tree has to be directly by the trail, that you can lift it with the big cylinder and the telescope. So you can lift every tree that goes into that machine from the space. So very cool to see. I hope you like it.